If over the past year, your memory hasn't quite been up to snuff, maybe you've been forgetting where you put your car keys or finding the right word or even what you did a couple weeks ago, you're not alone. Turns out the pandemic has been challenging to the memory. Today, we'll try to find out why. I'm Veronica Rickert, and this is Badger Talks. Today, we're talking to Professor Haley Vlach. She's an associate professor of educational sciences and an expert in how memory develops. Professor Vlach, hello.
Hi there.
So I'm curious about this. My memory, I think of it as being pretty good, but over the course of this long years plus pandemic, I felt like it was not quite up to snuff. And I started to see articles about other people reporting that same thing. Is this something you've experienced too, that there seems to be something kind of tricky going on with what the lifestyle and the pandemic does to your memory?
Yes, I absolutely have been suffering from forgetting little things here and there, but also some big events like birthdays of close friends. So I think that it's a pretty common experience during the pandemic to be feeling more forgetting than usual.
So what is your assessment about why that's happening? I wouldn't have expected that to be something that would be a side effect of what happened.
Well, it turns out that the pandemic is a perfect storm for causing forgetting. There are a number of reasons why. The first is that the pandemic has affected our daily routine. And it turns out that our daily routines are really important for our memory. Certain people or places can serve as memory cues to cue our brains to recall different things. So for instance, you might see somebody at work that cues you to recall information about them, or your office might recall you, you know, help you recall what you need to do that day. And in the absence of those cues, we experience more forgetting. Another reason that we experience more forgetting is that many of us are multitasking more than we ever have in our lives. The best example is parents who are working from home with their kids, trying to manage being a parent and being an employee at the same time. There's a long history of research that shows that multitasking is not efficient. We usually do a worse job in the two domains. And unfortunately, it encourages forgetting. And so you're more likely to forget some aspect of being a parent or some aspect of your work life that is important.
That all makes total sense. And I think about also what I experienced and what many people experienced, which was isolation and also anxiety humming along in the background so much of the time. Do those things have a factor in all of this?
Absolutely. So there are a lot of social emotional factors that are also contributing to our experiences of forgetting during the pandemic. So social isolation removes the people cues that I talked about earlier. But it also, unfortunately, encourages forgetting of our autobiographical memories, or in other words, the memories of our experiences of our sense of self. And that isolation becomes a really strong feeling that blocks us from recalling our sense of self. And we know from research on memory that those that are suffering through mental health issues or even just regular emotional day-to-day issues suffer from more forgetting than those who are not.
So I'm hoping there's good news. A lot of us are starting to move out of the pandemic zone. Are we going to get our better memories back, or is this kind of a permanent change?
Great question. There are some silver linings. So good news. One is that it's going to come back. Once we get back into that old routine that we had, those cues will be there. You'll see the person at work. You'll be in your office. The memory that you used to have will return. Another silver lining of the forgetting that we're experiencing now is that there are some things we might want to forget about the pandemic. This hasn't been a pleasant experience for most people, and it's healthy for our brains, our emotions, our sense of being to forget particularly negative experiences. It allows us to move beyond them and start to feel more positive emotions and have more positive experiences. So in other words, some of the forgetting that we're doing right now is adaptive and going to be helpful in the future.
So interesting. Professor Vlach, thank you so much for talking about this today.
Yeah, great to be here.
If you have questions for us or topic suggestions or want to comment on this Badger Talk, send us an email at covid19update@uc.wisc.edu. And for more information, you can go to covid19.impact.wisc.edu. This is Badger Talks.